There's been a wealth of new tools emerging in the Python space, powered by Rust, to solve one specific problem, making it easy to take a Python package or application and redistribute it as a standalone executable without needing the Python runtime installed. One of the latest new tools in this space is PyCrucible, written in Rust, and it has some of the simplest setup and configuration of any of those tools, although it's still very new and has only a minimal feature set. But it's stable enough to be worth a look, so let's take a look. Any Python project with a pyproject.toml file and a compatible project layout is a good candidate for working with PyCrucible. To get it set up, all you need to do is use pip install PyCrucible to add it to the virtual environment for your project. Next, you'll want to edit your project's pyproject.toml file to add some PyCrucible-specific options. The most basic one you need is some indication of what the entry point for your program is. Here, it's just main.py, and main.py here is just a Hello World program. You can also supply some PyCrucible-specific options. Debug, for instance, is useful to enable when you're first deploying a project with PyCrucible, as it gives you detailed feedback about what the PyCrucible bundler is doing. Generally, though, you can leave the options as is. The values shown here, by the way, are the defaults, and so they should work for the vast majority of projects. Next, we'll run PyCrucible to create our redistributable. All we need to do is run PyCrucible-e.o hello.exe, which will embed the package that is in the current working directory, and output it to hello.exe. And once the bundling is finished, you'll see a hello.exe show up in that directory. Now, if we run hello.exe, you'll see a directory named PyCrucible Payload appear, which is where our program is extracted into on its first run. You may also see some warnings, like this one, which pop up because we're running the bundled program inside an active env, but we can ignore that for now since most of the time that won't happen. And as you can see, our Hello World program has printed to the console. Note that when we rerun the program, it will simply use what's already in the extracted directory, if it already exists. So this needs to run in a directory where you have write permissions. The size of the resulting executable isn't small, though, and that's an inevitable consequence of using Python. For a Hello World like this, the exe is 20 megabytes, and it's extracted to a directory that fills about 50 megabytes. Because of the way Python works, it's difficult to minimize a distribution by removing unused modules or performing selective compilation. But the whole thing does run, as is, with no external dependencies, and that's what's important. Now, the best thing about PyCrucible is we don't have to compile anything. I don't need the Rust compiler or any other Rust tooling apart from what I installed with pip install. So that alone makes it a compelling choice if you just want a drop-in and go solution for making a Python program redistributable. And that's it for this episode. If you liked it, leave a comment below. And don't forget to follow Dev with Serdar and InfoWorld on Facebook, YouTube, and InfoWorld.com.